Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will explain how to customize rows and columns in a Blazor pivot table. I will show you how to customize the height of a row, width of a column, and grid lines. You will also see how to customize the display of the cell content using text wrap and clip mode properties. First, I will open an existing Blazor application that has a pivot table with a list of data retrieved from the product details data source. If you want to know how to get started with the Blazor pivot table component, refer to the video linked in the card above. I will run this application to show the initial output. You can see the pivot table rendered with the defined data source. By default, the row height of a pivot table is 30 pixels, and column width is 110 pixels. If you want to customize the height and width based on the cell content, use the row height and column width properties. To demonstrate, I add the Pivot View Grid Settings tag and define the row height property and set its value to 60 pixels. Then, I define the column width property and set its value to 200 pixels. The pivot table is now rendered with the custom row height and column width. You can also resize the width of a column in the UI by dragging its right edge. Notice here, when I resize the column to a smaller width, the content of the cell exceeds the boundary and truncates the text. This is the default clip mode behavior. Apart from this, the Syncfusion Blazor pivot table also supports two other clip modes, ellipsis and ellipsis with tooltip. Let me demonstrate the ellipsis with tooltip mode. Inside the Pivot View Grid settings, I define the clip mode property and set the value to ellipsis with tooltip. When I resize the column and the cell content overflows its area, see the ellipsis is displayed with a tooltip. Suppose you want to display the cell content in a new line instead of showing the ellipsis. Define the Allow Text Wrap property and set its value to true. Look here, when I resize the column, the text wraps up and is displayed in the next line. By default, the content in the row, column, and value headers of the pivot table is left aligned, while the value cells are right aligned. In addition to these positions, the pivot table also supports center and justify positions. In this example, I will show you how to align the row header content to the right position. To do this, I will define the Pivot View Events tag. Add the Before Columns Render event with the Event Handler Column Render. I will also set the T-Value property here. Then, I will define the Column Render Event Handler that receives the argument of type Column Render Event Args. Within this method, I will check if the row headers are not null and set the text align to right. The row headers in the pivot table are right aligned. Similarly, you can align the content of column headers, value headers, and value cells using the Before Columns Render event. Next, you will see how to select a record using the Selection Mode property. Before that, I will remove the Before Column Render event definition, as I want to display the row headers content aligned to the left. I define the Allow Selection property and set its value to true. Look, I can select a row by clicking on a record. Along with this default row selection, the Syncfusion Blazor pivot table supports three more types of selection modes, namely column, cell, and both. Now, I will show you how to select a cell on the pivot table. I define the Pivot View Selection Settings tag and add the mode property to set the value as cell. Now, I can select a cell on the pivot table because the selection mode is set to cell. Notice here, you can select only one cell at a time because the default selection type is single. If you want to select more than one record at a time, you can use the selection type property. To do that, I define the property, type, and set the value to multiple. Now, you will be able to select multiple cells at a time using the control key. Finally, I will show you how to customize grid lines. By default, the pivot table displays both horizontal and vertical grid lines. Apart from this default option, the Syncfusion Blazor pivot table also supports horizontal, vertical, and none options. To display only vertical grid lines, I define the grid lines property in the Pivot View Grid Settings definition and set the value to vertical. You can see the pivot table rendered with vertical grid lines alone. In this video, you have seen how to customize the height of a row, width of a column, and grid lines on the pivot table. If you would like to see the working example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Blazor products through our community license. If you found this video useful, do like the video and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.